morning, and myself Baswa. I am working as assistant professor in St. Martin Engineering College and the ECE department. And today I am going to deliver a lecture on fundamentals of Internet of Things. As everyone know, the IoT is the latest buzzword in the industries or in healthcare and many domains. So it is very important to know about Internet of Things. So because we are using IoT based devices in our day-to-day life, and how much it is influencing us, that is playing a very vital role in our day-to-day life. So let us start with the Internet of Things. So basically, in the normal, I will start with an introduction. In earlier, we had embedded devices where it was a combination of hardware and software, and the embedded based devices can do a dedicated task, means unique applications. So in the Internet of Things, what we are doing is, so that embedded applications we are imparting with an internet, means we are connecting with an internet, and that with that internet we can share all the informations towards the end users by using some network protocols and cloud. So that is the importance of Internet of Things. So let us come to the definition of Internet of Things. So definition. So Internet of Things is a technology where the things which have a unique code which are connected over an internet is called as an Internet of Things. So other way I can define as, Internet of Things is a computing concept. IoT, it is a computing concept. So what it means, the definition of Internet of Thing is, it is like a computing concept. Computing concept in the sense, we are going to have a multiple kind of applications where we are computing what kind of devices will work through different domain. So in the computing concept, what it will describes an idea of physical object. Every day we have a physical object which are coming across us, which are connected to an internet and being able to identify themselves to the other devices. That is nothing but Internet of Things. So in the brief way I can tell that, if any devices have a unique identity like IP address, or where all the devices which are connected over an internet, and that is used to acquire the information, send the information to others and do both. So that is the categorization of Internet of Things. So let us come to the basic, why IoT matters. Why IoT matters? As I told you, all the devices which are connected to internet, if for example, if something connected to internet has sent the information and it retrieve the information from the outside world, and it will do both. So that is the purpose of IoT devices. For example, we can say, you take a soil moisture sensors or water level sensor or smoke sensors. What these are the things, means it has some unique identity. What it will do, it will acquire the data from the outside world, and that information will be sent to the another user for the action, and it will do both. So this is the three categorizations of IoT where we need to learn it. These are the essential part that need to be incorporated while studying an Internet of Things. So now let's move towards the characteristics of an IoT technology. So where we have a different characterizations and the properties of Internet of Things, that is characteristics of IoT. So let us talk about characteristics. We can call it as properties of Internet of Things. So the characteristics of IoT are in different domains. I can call it as dynamic and self-adapting. And the second one is self-configuring. The third one is interoperable communication protocol. And the fourth one is unique identity. So these are the major characteristics of any IoT devices. By this also we can define then what is an Internet of Things. The first let us discuss about dynamic and self-adapting. So as we know that IoT devices and IoT technology based devices have a self-adapting capability, and if anything changes happening outside the environment or operating conditions or sensor environment, so automatically, dynamically it will adapt the changes happening in the environment. And also for example, better example I can say is surveillance systems of a camera. So it will operate in the conditions, means condition may be changes from day and night. So for example, if someone object or some person is moving from the camera, from the front of the camera, so what happens, the resolutions maybe get decreases. So according to that conditions, our IoT devices should be adapted, means it has a capability of adapting changes in the environmental conditions or operation conditions or sensor environment. So I told the examples of surveillance system. It is a beautiful example for dynamic and self-adapting. Similarly, self-configuring. Self-configuring in the sense IoT devices may have a capability of self-configuring. That means it allows large number of devices work together and provide a common functionality. That is nothing but self-configuring. The best example we can call it as weather monitoring system. In the weather monitoring system is based on IoT, where it has many kind of sensors and devices that works together, and finally it will share all the information to an end node. So and if anything software updates or any other things are there, it will update automatically. So that is nothing but self-configuring capability. If you install any other software also, the devices has to incorporate that software updations automatically by itself. So next we can call it an interoperable communication protocols. So as we know that the IoT devices have a main three things. It should have a devices, that is software and hardware. Along with that we need internet. So internet is nothing but it comes under different network protocols. So IoT devices allows different interoperable communication protocols for communicating among each other within a device. So for that we have a different communications protocols. As we know that in IoT model we have four protocols we are using layers. One is network layer, application layer, transport layer and link layer. So these are the different network protocol which we are using within our devices for communicating each other. So this and next one, unique identity. Unique identity in the sense each IoT devices, means the device which are present on IoT device, have different unique identity. Different unique identity is in the sense it is having separate IP address or any kind of like RFID
signals. So there are different tags which are present for identifying the devices, so which are connected over internet. Now we can define systematically by taking the characteristics of this IoT. So now I can tell, so IoT is a technology which has dynamic and self-adapting capability, self-configuring and interoperable communication protocol, and it has unique identity connected over internet, is called as IoT. So other way, in general definition, I can call it as the things which are have unique identity, which are connected over a internet, and which has dynamic and self-adapting capability, and which has interoperable communication protocol, is called as an Internet of Things. These are the very important characteristics of an IoT. So next, let us look at the applications of IoT. Applications of IoT. So in other way, I can call it as major applications areas of an IoT, right? So as you know that most of the field IoT devices are used, it plays a very vital role. The first, I can divide into different category of applications. First one I can call it as home. The second one we can call it as cities, environment, in energy, and we can call it as in safety devices, and retails. So these are the major applications areas of an IoT. So let us come to the home. So most of the time, 80% of the devices in homes are very, nowadays are smart. Like we have a smart lighting system, and smart home automation system, and means everything, the smart home, smart TVs, everywhere we are using an IoT devices. For home, we have a smart lighting. In the smart lighting, what we are doing, we are using any one of the processor or controller inside it, and we will be using different kind of light sensor which is interfaced to a Raspberry Pi, and in the Raspberry Pi we have a built-in Wi-Fi by using which we can control our light by sitting at anywhere away from the home by using third party applications. Over IP, we are giving the different IP addresses for that particular. And next one is cities. So as we know that central government has very supportive towards the smart cities, where we can do a smart parking system, structural health monitoring system, that are comes under cities. So in the environment, and we have a weather monitoring systems and greenhouse control system, so that are comes under environment, means temperature monitoring, humidity monitoring. So this can be monitored with the help of the IoT technology or IoT devices. So energy, that is nothing but a very important application, that is we will be having a smart grid. The power saving mechanisms in electronics, meters, that is also one of the applications comes under energy. And the safety wearable devices, I can call it as safety wearable devices. So nowadays everyone are using smart watches, and with that there are many sensors are incorporated to it, like heartbeat we can monitor. So we have a safety devices, electronic gadgets by using which we can monitor our health condition also. So that is comes under safety wearable devices. And similarly in the retails, we have a automatic vending machines. So we can see when we go to any shopping malls where in the automatic vending machine, if you put any amount or coins, so you can get chocolates. So we can have a different kind of applications that are based on and IoT. So these are the important applications, major application areas of Internet of Things. We have a many more. We have a banking where we have a console, means point of sales, by using which we can get our data over the internet also. And these are the very important applications of IoT. That's all. Thank you.